Arun Kumar, Secretary, Ministry of Mines, Government of India. Excellency George Castaneda, Ambassador of Peru in India. Mr. D.K. Sinha, IG Forest, Ministry of Environment and Forest. Mr. Dilip Chenoy, Secretary General, FICCI. Distinguished captains of the industry, guests, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of FICCI and its non-ferrous metal community, it gives me an immense pleasure to welcome all of you this morning for a day's conference on the subject Landscape for Non-Ferrous Metals in India, Vision 2030. I would like to extend my gratitude to Sri Arun Kumar, Secretary Ministry of Mines, Excellency George Castaneda, Ambassador of Peru, and Sri Deepak Kumar Sinha, IG Forest, for sparing their time and being with us this morning for the inaugural session. Non-ferrous metal industry derives its significance from the fact that industry works like a virtual cycle in the economy. The industry enables growth of infrastructure, automobiles, telecom, electricals, etc. by helping meet the demand of various non-ferrous metals on one hand and on other hand to boost the manufacturing sector. In fact, it will be a very crucial part of the campaigns like Make in India, Smart Cities, National Solar Mission, as well as initiatives in the defense sector. The non-ferrous metal industry is witnessing a paradigm shift in the way metals will be consumed in the future. With a steady growth in demand, producers would move beyond traditional stands. Like in India, we have been having a major consumption of non-ferrous metals like aluminium in electrical segment, transmission and cables, etc. Automotive and building segments to shift to newer applications offered by defense, aerospace, hybrid and electrical vehicles, and various initiatives in the railway and transportation sector. I suppose the importance of non-ferrous metal industry in any country and more so in a developing country like India is well recognized and established. And it is also an established fact that we have huge mineral resources, both ferrous and non-ferrous metal in this country, and only a very fraction of them have been explored or are in use. So as Mr. Chinoy was mentioning, it is a, you know, some of these non-ferrous metals like aluminium, etc. are highly power intensive. And we have all the necessary ingredients to see that we produce these metals in a most competitive manner at globally competitive cost. In fact, with our vast reserves of coal, with a better, cleaner technology to produce power out of coal, we can produce power at most competitive rates in this country. And if we are able to explore our reserves of bauxite, we can produce aluminium at the lowest costs anywhere produced in the world. Same way, we have huge reserves of copper ore, probably a lot more needs to be done for exploration there. Some areas they are pretty rich, and today India is a quarter of copper. We can turn into a situation that we have enough copper for our use, as well as we have surplus for the rest of the world. Zinc, we have one of the largest producers of zinc in the world in the country. Again, we have very good grade zinc ore, and more exploration can really lead to this situation. Now, in the past, there might have been various issues relating to exploration of mineral resources, but I think we have come a long way. The government put up an excellent mineral policy with a transparent system, and only thing which I would urge Mr. Arun Kumar Secretary here, that if we can see that, you know, auction of mineral resources are put on a fast track, so that Indian industry can really benefit and come up with more value addition within the country. It will help country, and it will help not only the producers but also the consumers of the non-ferrous metals, where the demand is growing significantly in the country. So some of the challenges which are day-to-day related challenges will remain, and I suppose the dialogue with the government and the specific stakeholders is the answer for that purpose. Nevertheless, I suppose time has come really for the industry to think beyond day-to-day problems, beyond their horizon of next 3 months, 6 months, and for that matter, I suppose this today's subject is very, very valid, that what is our vision for non-ferrous metals in India 2030. And here we have to see that as a nation, how can we really harness our potential fully for the benefit of not only the industry but ultimately the consuming industries of the non-ferrous metals. And here I suppose today's deliberations will help in coming out what should be the long-term plans, short-term, medium-term plans, and how various stakeholders can really contribute without really getting so much bothered about our certain issues which we can really sit across with the government authorities and sort it out. Our mineral resources are mostly in tribal areas as well as in forest areas, and here I suppose we have to really coordinate well with the Ministry of Environment and Forest to see that we can do a sustainable mining, we can see that the requirement of the local population is met. Government has taken the initiative of creating the mineral fund, and beyond that also industry should really be able to come forward to address any such concerns. So instead of concentrating more on concerns, we must really be looking at opportunities, and surely the concerns coming in the way need to be addressed, and I am sure they will be addressed. So thank you very much for being with us this morning and for the session. Thank you.